And back at the Winnipeg Arena, I'm Don Whitman with John Garrett and Scott Oak as we prepare to start the second overtime. We haven't had a goal scored since the 1925 mark of period two when Esa Tikkanen beat Stefan Beauregard. All three Jet goals were scored against Bill Radford in the first period. And again, we welcome Sports Channel America viewers to the Winnipeg Arena. The second overtime period about to get underway. Both Bill Radford and Stefan Beauregard making some big saves in the final minute of the first overtime period.
And the fatigue factor could come in for Bill Radford, although Stefan Beauregard came in partway through the second period. Radford's been in for the whole four periods.
Ashton taken in against the boards by Greg. McDermott tried to move the puck. It comes back to the line. Ellett takes the long shot wide of the net. Fenton gathers it in for Winnipeg to McDermott. McDermott looking out front for Fenton, and it's cleared to the boards to Messier. He dumps it out of the zone. Olsson shoots it back in. Greg gets it ahead to Anderson. Anderson to Messier. Messier working against Ellett. Messier still controlling. Checked by Olsson, gets it back to the net. Still hanging on. Over to Steve Smith. There's the shot. Beauregard the save. And then Anderson is knocked into Beauregard by Brent Ashton.
Steve Smith was waiting for some help in front of Stefan Beauregard. It never came. The Jets did a good job, and there you can see the result. Craig Simpson's down. Len Anderson was held up. And Beauregard saw that shot all the way and made the save.
Well, Craig Simpson's favorite spot is directly in front of the goaltender.
Here's the replay back to Steve Smith, and watch Smith. He's waiting for somebody to get in front of the goaltender, but it just doesn't happen. And there's Paul McDermott giving Simpson a shot, and Brent Ashton knocking Glenn Anderson down. Here he comes, and Olsson is the only player that even comes close to screening the goalie, and he makes sure that he's on the side, and Beauregard makes the save.
Lamb against Steen in the faceoff to the right of Beauregard. Donnelly picks it up, gets it out of the zone. Referee Dan Marinelli rules that Steen made contact with a high stick. So as a result, a whistle on the play and the faceoff at the line.
John Muckler very intense on that Edmonton bench. He lets his feelings show a little more than the Winnipeg Jets coach Bob Murdoch. It's hard to tell that you're in the double overtime when you look at the face of coach Bob Murdoch.
Well, there'll be some tired hockey players tonight at the conclusion of this one. There'll be some fans who might be a little late in getting to work tomorrow morning. Steen steals it. Here's Steen going in alone. He's hauled down by Ruotsalainen. And there's a penalty coming up, the first one of overtime.
This is the first penalty called in the last 30 minutes. And this one, Ruotsalainen coughed up the puck, and Steen's got a breakaway. There's Steen on the breakaway, and Ruotsalainen quits skating and gives him a tug as Steve Smith was coming back, had the angle on Steen, but I think Steen would have been in. And this is a good penalty by Ruotsalainen to haul down Thomas Steen. Hope his penalty killers can come up big again. They have all night.
Well, Ruotsalainen made a game-saving play on Dale Hawerchuk, preventing him from getting a pass across to Dave McElwain on a two-on-one. And he may have saved the game there in this second overtime period by hauling down Thomas Steen. The Jets so far tonight have not clicked on the power play.
0 for 7. Would you have called a penalty shot? Steen almost had a breakaway.
Ellett lets it go, score!
The Winnipeg Jets on the power play. Thomas Steen kicks it back to Ellett. He moves in and just lets it rip. Stick side low on Bill Ranford. Power play goal for the Winnipeg Jets. Steen, watch Steen. Kicks it back to Ellett. He's on his forehand. Just moves in the middle and lets it go, and it beats goaltender Bill Ranford.
Well, John Garrett, you and I have both been at games at Chicago Stadium, considered to be the noisiest building in the league. I think tonight this Winnipeg Arena would rival anything we've ever heard in Chicago.
The ovation when Ellett put that puck in was deafening, even with our headsets on. And you see the fans are still standing here for the Winnipeg Jets.
Very few have left the building. Ellett from Steen at 109, a power play goal, and the Winnipeg Jets are one win away from knocking off the Edmonton Oilers in this Spike Division semifinal. These fans just don't want to go home.
They have fun when they come to the hockey game. The charge of the White Brigade is carried on. It took a long time here tonight to be successful, but it didn't double overtime.